It all begins here again, Palm Sunday. It is as if during the season of Lent, we've been wandering around outside the gates of Jerusalem, and today, literally, we crossed the threshold into Holy Week. Something significant changes, if we're paying attention. Palms waving, we parade down the street crying, Hosanna! Soon, the mood will shift as we discover that King may mean something altogether different than we had imagined, but today is Hosanna. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord.
Peace in heaven and glory in the highest.
Let us pray. Assist us mercifully with your help, O Lord God of our salvation, that we may enter with joy upon the contemplation of those mighty acts whereby you have given us life and immortality through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, Why are you doing this? Just say, The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately. They went and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, What are you doing untying the colt? They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed him to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is right to praise you, Almighty God, for the acts of love by which you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. On this day, he entered into the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was proclaimed as King of Kings by those who spread their garments and branches of palm along his way. Let these branches be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may evermore hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life, who lives and reigns in glory with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey!
The King is coming!
Hey!
Jesus is coming!
Jesus!
Hosanna! Hosanna!
Woo! Hosanna! Woo!
Hosanna!
Hosanna! The King! Hosanna!
Now at this time, we will distribute the palms. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. I got you, Philip. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain and entered not into glory before he was crucified. Mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, in your tender love for the human race, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon Him our nature and to suffer death upon the cross, giving us the example of His great humility. Mercifully grant that we may walk in the way of His suffering and also share in His resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of Holy Scripture.
The first lesson, Isaiah chapter 50. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning He wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Please read with me in unison Psalm 31. Have mercy on me, O Lord,
for I am in trouble.
My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly.
For my life is wasted with grief,
and my ears with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction,
and my bones are consumed.
I have become a reproach to all my enemies,
and even to my neighbors,
a dismay to those of my acquaintance. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. I am forgotten like a dead man, out of mind. I am as useless as a broken pot. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life. But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Make your face to shine upon your servant, and in your loving kindness save me.
A reading from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Sacred head, soul.
passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He answered him,
"You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again,
"Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you?"
But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them,
"Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again,
"Then what do you want me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted back,
"Crucify him!"
Pilate asked them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him!"
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak. And after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him.
"Hail, King of the Jews!"
They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription on the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him, they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha! You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him, when it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3:00, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani,"
which means, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said,
"Listen, he's calling for Elijah."
And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down."
Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now, when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was God's son." The prayers of the people. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, especially Joe, our president, Kamala, our vice president, Greg, our governor, and Betsy, our mayor, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, especially those we now name.
Victims and survivors of the Boulder shootings.
For those who don't have warm places to sleep on cold nights.
The Episcopal churches in Fort Worth.
For those suffering from COVID and the effects of COVID.
Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Jesus Christ, our Savior, on this day you received the worship of those who held you as their King. Accept our praise and adoration, our worship and love, and grant that we, who now confess you with our lips, may never fail to give you the service of our lives. For the honor of your holy name, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to the Lord. All things come from thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins he was lifted high upon the cross that he might draw the whole world to himself. And by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious God, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Creator of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament
and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace.
and at the last day bring us with blessed Luke and all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. Give us your peace.
These are holy gifts of God for you, holy people of God. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Here, this is the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. This is the body of Christ.
Let us pray.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And may the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, be upon you this day in all the days of your lives.
Amen. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.